2022 of BIMTECH, the Birla Institute of Management Technology. And we have with us the chief guest of the day, Mr. G.N. Bajpai, the former chairman of SEBI and LIC Mumbai. Welcome to 10 years, sir.
Thank you.
So in your address today, you spoke in length about the ESGs. And so how far do you think the Indian INCs has fared in ESGs, and what more needs to be done to inspire the Indian companies to incorporate ESGs more in their decision making?
See, Indian corporates are now already organized to deal with this issue, which is very imminent and is going to be important for their own sustainability. Right now, what is important for them to know is how they can link the economic benefits out of the compliance with the ESG.
Okay. And so taking this conversation forward, in the past few years, certain European nations, you know, have imposed carbon taxes to control their emissions. So do you think India should also impose a similar tax to control the emissions?
Well, that's a negative approach to dealing with an issue. I would always recommend a positive approach. And positive approach is, as I was quoting in my own speech also, the research analysis done by Murdoch in Financial Times, that it is makes an economic sense to be doing ESG.
Yes.
And in case this more of researches come up and more of discussion with the academics takes place, how they can link the ESG goals with economic value add, I'm sure this will happen.
Yeah, that's valid also, I think.
Yes.
And lastly, I want to ask you, like, today is the foundation day of BIMTECH. So what would be your message to all the students of this institute who are also the global leaders of the tomorrow?
Well, my message would be that you have to remain socially conscious.
Yeah.
That you are a part of the privileged group. And therefore, the benefits of all that you derive out of this privilege should also be shared with others in the society who do not have equal opportunity.
Very well said, sir. I must say, thank you so much for talking to us.
Welcome.
I'm Shelly Agarwal and you're watching 10 News.
Thank you.